Oh, God. It's all protein.
How spicy is this? Because I'm a little bit of a wuss.
1 to 10, probably a 7.
She was born in the outskirts of Seoul to an American GI and a young Korean woman. He was born in Alsace, France, land of pork and cabbage. She was put up for adoption at 3 and then lovingly raised in Virginia by her new family. He was 16 when he began his apprenticeship. She found her birth mother when she was 19. He came to America and became one of the world's greatest chefs. They fell in love and married over a decade ago. Now, Jean-Georges and Marja return to her birthplace to chronicle the tastes and traditions of Korea. These are the Kimchi Chronicles.
The 21st century is looking a lot like Korea's best yet. South Korea, roughly the size of Kentucky, has become the darling of the industrial world, globally feeding it with electronics and automobiles, not to mention kimchi. And Koreans have become leaders in design, computer animation, and fashion. But when it comes to restaurants, all that style goes right out the window. The fact is, Korean restaurants are all about the food. From the high-end fine dining destinations to the small tucked away hole in the walls. At the end of the day, Korean diners choose where they eat based entirely on the food. It always comes down to what's on the plate or in the bowl. Koreans care so much about the quality of the food that sometimes the best dishes aren't even in the confines of a restaurant. But like people everywhere in the modern world, South Koreans often need to grab something on the run. And Korean street food, or bunjik, offers some of the best eating, period.
Delicious.
Every May 5th is Children's Day in Korea. Celebrations happen all over the place, including Gyeonghigung Palace, where it's all about the kids. There were displays of Taekwondo, the Korean martial art. And there were also magical dance troupes of ladies who move like muses and keep a driving beat on the drums at the same time. After all that expenditure of energy, I was feeling a bit peckish. I spent the rest of the day in Insadong, one of my favorite shopping neighborhoods, with Sue Park, who's a DJ friend from Seoul. As usual, my cousin was running late, so Sue and I had a pre-snack snack of a popular morning pastry known by its English name.
Correct me if I'm wrong, this looks like something...
Yes, exactly. A steamy pile of poo.
Yeah,
yes, exactly.
I'm gonna say it.
So it's got red bean.
Red bean paste.
A lot of milk in the batter, so it's super, super soft. Very, very fluffy.
I can't wait, it looks delicious.
There was a popular fashion brand called Dalgi, and you can see like a little girl
okay.
with a strawberry head, and she had a friend called Dongsimi, hence the name of the brand, and it's really popular.
Huge!
Yeah, people find it hilarious.
It's good to see the Koreans have a sense of humor.
Oh, definitely.
I love it. What else are they selling? Oh, it looks like strawberry juice.
Oh,
citrus tea?
Definitely.
Yeah,
sure.
Great, I love citrus tea.
Yes, the shape of poo is the same everywhere in the world.
Mm. It's hot.
Oh. I'm
How was your first bite of poo?
I didn't know I loved poo.
It's great.
Good? Mm. Is it soft and all fluffy?
And hot.
Very so hot.
Since sugar shock hadn't yet set in, why not another sweet? Kanjeong is sort of like a Korean version of a Rice Krispie treat, made with puffed rice, molten rice syrup, and nuts.
I love rice cakes.
Oh, these are really
the whole
good
stall,
traditional
I love
snacks.
It. I can't wait to try.
Hello.
Oh. What's this?
This is the sari and sari.
So these are like basically Rice Krispies.
Okay.
Yeah. Pumpkin seeds.
Peanuts and black sesame.
Wow, what is this?
That is honey.
Okay.
Mixed with a little bit of fruit juice. There is absolutely no sugar in all these.
All these treats? Are you serious? Mm-hmm.
Yep.
That's amazing. Great. Ooh, look at that.
Oh, wow. I love it.
It's seriously really like a Rice Krispie. Yeah.
You have to mix it while it's still hot.
Yeah.
Well, that's a talent in and of itself.
Right? 이거 몇 년 동안 하셨어요? 얼마나 오래 하셨어요?
제가 10년 가까이 했죠.
Oh, wow. 10 years.
10 years, wow. He's an artiste.
Definitely.
Wow.
Okay. This is gonna cool down really quickly. So he's gonna cut into little pieces after it's cooled down.
I can't wait to taste it. Is this an old family recipe?
이거 직접 개발하신 거예요?
예.
It's his own recipe.
Smart. Sometimes it looks delicious.
Mmm.
Oh, good.
It's really good.
And it's definitely a step up from the traditional Rice Krispie.
Very, very good.
Next up was Dragon's Beard, where the showmanship was just as sweet as a candy.
This is Korea traditional sweet, Dragon's Beard. This is lump of honey, okay? Honey, I love you, honey.
Why is it so hard?
Honey and glutinous rice fermented for 2 weeks, so it's very hard. Okay. Oh, this is Dragon's Hair. Make a hole. Yeah, make a hole. Wow. Oh, Dunkin' Donut. Yeah. I love it. Slowly, little by little. I'll make 16,384 strings. 1, 2, 4 strings. Next one, 18, right?
Right.
16.
Yeah, it's like 90.
64, 1, 1, 8, 2, 2, 56.
Yeah.
Okay. Final term, middle size, 1,034.
Oh my god.
But take it easy. Now finish the show, must go on. Oh, 2048, 4096, 8192, last count, 16,384 strings.
Wow!
OMG, oh my god! Looks like your hair!
Okay. Well, hopefully not anytime soon.
Okay. Outside of honey, inside is seven kind of nuts, many footing, and my love too. Dragon's beer.
Yum, so good.
But not everything was so easy and sweet. My Korean cousins and friends love to nibble on bondaegi, silkworm larvae, that get no sauce, just a boil. So there's nothing to distract from their distinct flavor. And even though I try to stay open-minded, I'm still not quite used to chewing something that tastes distinctly like bug.
Protein.
Soju. We're doing street food today.
Good.
Excellent.
In Korea, I think the street food is everywhere.
It's everywhere. We're going to do a Korean-American version of street food.
This is American street food.
One of my favorite American street foods is hot dogs. And he's added a little Korean element to it, so.
You want to take care of the...
Sure.
I'm going to give some, on the hot dog, some spicy Korean mustard.
Good.
On a little bit of a kimchi relish on top of the hot dogs.
So now this is, how spicy is this? Because I'm a little bit of a wuss with spice. I
just 1 to 10, probably a 7.
Oh, that's a bit.
But we're going to sweet it up with a...
I like spicy.
You're going to watch me sweat, JJ. You're going to watch me sweat.
We're going to sweeten it up with a honey on some rice vinegar. You guys are ready?
You're good.
Oh, yeah.
You don't do
many
this
years.
Home. I haven't seen this action at home.
It's all before you wake up. I like to be invisible when it comes to the kitchen.
So here we go. Marja, you want to put a little mustard on top?
Sure. Now, how hot is this on a scale of 1?
A little bit. Just a little line on top of the hot dogs.
Line, okay.
What is this? What kind of oil? Brown rice vinegar?
Yeah. Rice vinegar.
Just 2 tablespoons of this?
2 tablespoons of this. So we could try to create like a sweet and sour. Plus the spicy
really
kimchi.
That's very Asian, isn't it? The sweet and the sour always mixed in.
I love that.
Same thing. I love that mix.
That mix is the best.
Well, I have to say Spice Market is one of our favorite restaurants. Yeah.
Thank you.
It really is.
I concur.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And a little bit of a...
It's going to be worth a free meal or two, right?
Here we go, one more.
Okay.
And if you want to top it with a little bit of a kimchi on top.
Yeah.
It should be nice.
Oh, it does smell good.
You know, usually relish are always like a sweet and a little sour, so... I think the kimchi works so well. If we do this in Central Park, we'll be very popular.
Yeah, exactly.
You got
to... It's not your classic thing. You think of Korean food, we're having hot dogs. I love it.
Look at that.
Okay,
that good.
One more to go here.
Okay, I'll do the mustard.
All right.
There we go.
A work of art.
Great.
Have a bite.
My favorite food. Here, babe.
I'm taking this one.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Good. Looks good.
Enjoy.
Cheers.
In Korean hot dogs.
How do we say I'm hungry again?
Cheers.
In Korean?
Naegopa.
Naegopa?
Yeah.
Naegopa. How do you say it's good?
Maxiso.
Oh, that's good.
That's a flavor, huh?
No, that is so good. Really? Yeah. Beers?
Okay.
Australian.
Oh, this is really good.
This is so good.
I think it's too spicy for you or
no? No, this is perfect. I really didn't get much mustard, but this is perfect for me.
I got your serving.
Any north of this and it's just not pleasurable for me. Did you know that I am Goodwill Ambassador for Seoul? Did I tell you that?
Oh my gosh, that's amazing.
Mm.
You were there not too long ago, right?
Mm, I love it there. It was my dad. Spent a lot of his working life in Korea. Oh,
I didn't know that.
Yeah, he was an accountant, and one of his clients was the World Bank, and they basically put him in charge of Korea. And my entire childhood, in fact, we make fun of my dad to this day. Korea is at the forefront of technology and cross. And we'd all like, Korea. Dad would tell anybody who'd listen, or wow. Not even listening, he'd tell them.
That's amazing.
Cheers. Oh, yeah. Now, how do we say cheers?
Konbei.
Konbei.
I'll have that too.
I always take my friends out for street food when they come to visit me in Korea. My actress friend Heather Graham is not only gorgeous, she's becoming ever more adventurous when it comes to trying new foods. We met in Busan, Korea's second largest city and the world's fifth biggest port. Located in the southeast corner of the peninsula, there's a lot of great street food to choose from in Busan. The city is famous for odang, skewered fish cakes served in hot broth, as well as tteokbokki, long rice cakes in a spicy sauce that Koreans chow down on like Americans do hot dogs. And lots of pan-fried mandu, dumplings, which Busan is also known for, and which are Heather's game. In Seoul, Heather and I did our nighttime street food eating at Gwangjang Market, which serves food that can compete with any restaurant anywhere. For Heather's sake, we went more vegetarian with gimbap, vegetable and rice rolls that are wrapped in seaweed. I didn't get Heather to try everything, but she is now officially a fellow bindaetteok freak. Bindaetteok are the crispy mung bean pancakes that I can never get enough of.
This is one of my favorite foods.
Wow, that onion thing is so good.
Isn't it?
Can I make that?
Easy. Mmm, so good.
I've been waiting the whole trip for this, and it was worth it. So good.
Don't eat too much, huh? We have a lot of food coming up.
I'm preparing for the next Wolverine. I eat 8 meals a day.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
They're usually like this. This is 8 cheat meals a day, but I'm going for it.
Are you cooking those 8 meals?
No, I'm not.
So good.
Shall I get started here?
Yeah, the next street food we're going to do is one of the Americans' favorite, is a lobster roll.
Love.
So, but I'm grilling my lobster. It's just on a grill. We're going to do a scallion, kind of chili, mayonnaise.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. Yep, it should be good.
Darling, this would be nice tomorrow night.
Thank you.
Done.
I'm coming over.
This is a steel trap. It's going in.
Absolutely. Sesame oil.
A teaspoon as well.
Got it.
And then we're going to put about 3-4 tablespoons of mayonnaise.
Vinegar?
Yes. A couple of those.
Two of those,
yeah.
We're going to test it to see if it's a...
What's
the
one?
Rice
one.
To me, quality of the mayonnaise is everything.
Yeah.
Right? This is good? Good mayonnaise?
It's excellent. 5 of those. Good we need point. A lot of mayonnaise.
5 of those?
Yeah.
Oh, so this is the low calorie meal of the day.
Absolutely.
Go.
Okay.
Let's test this.
So is this authentic Korean cooking?
No. This is fusion, a la Jean George.
Okay.
Almost ready.
That quick?
Yeah, the lobster tail just blanched before, and we just cut him in half on a little bit of olive oil and grill it.
Blanched means just on a very hot grill.
No, when you blanch it, you put in a pot of water. Just put them in there, boiling water for like 2 minutes.
Right.
So just to put him asleep and pre-cook him.
Yeah, that's right.
Let's see.
There we go.
Oh, that was great.
There's hardly any butter on there.
A little bit.
There's plenty, Marshall. There's plenty.
Yep. Chop it up.
Yep.
Then we're gonna toss it in the mayonnaise.
Oh, I see,
right.
It should be fine.
I've got plastic gloves.
Do you have any feeling in your hands or fingers?
I do. That's behind you. Maybe a little more tolerance. Right. And I give you the tail to cut.
That's so easy.
It's just, I think grilled lobster has more flavor than boiled lobster.
Definitely.
So,
I agree. You didn't put any marinade or
nothing.
Anything?
Yeah, all the flavor's going to be in the mayonnaise. Here we go. You're going to cut it up.
Careful. Do you want some?
All right. I'm trying to be tough. I'm in action movies for crying out loud. I should be able to, touch a lobster. Yeah, right. This is it.
I give it a tong.
The gig's up.
Yeah. There's some
tongs. No tongs needed. Is that too chunky? I like chunky.
Perfect.
Okay,
there.
Thank you. Wait. Ha. Chop. Yeah. Hey ho.
Here we go. That's cool. we're gonna fill up those those buns.
Oh my god.
Yeah, we'll fill up the buns.
He's too genius. He really is.
It's a simple thing. Oh. There you go.
Good one.
Deb.
Thank you, darling.
Alright. Right.
Thanks, Deb.
Oh, that looks so good.
It's disgusting.
Is it spicy or is it okay?
It's got just the perfect amount of heat.
Great.
This is delicious.
To die.
Fantastic.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
Happy lobster.
Happy lobster.
Goodbye, sweetie.
Love the street food.
Stop it.
Seriously, if I saw this in the street, I'd never go inside.
In Korea, there's notable street food outside the big cities, too. In the port town of Sokcho, in the northeastern corner of South Korea, the street food takes on a distinctly briny character. Sokcho is famous for its squid, particularly dried ojingo, which they sell to young and old alike. And they do squid fresh, too. Ojingo sundae is a North Korean dish of local squid that gets stuffed and steamed before being sliced and sauteed until crisp.
Fried shrimp.
This is all from Sokcho. This is seafood.
이모 여기 이거 새우가 다 속초에서 온 거예요?
네.
That's the secret.
That's the secret. Okay. It must be very good because you can always tell a good place.
You can see the lines.
By the line, it like wraps around. We've been waiting half an hour.
Yeah.
All right. Wow.
예쁘네요.
감사합니다.
네. 꼭 한 번.
알았어요.
That's good.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow. Oh, beer too. Oh,
finally.
Come there. Yeah. I knew I bought enough.
Right.
Babe, what are you doing over here with this chicken?
We're gonna do like a spicy chicken sandwich.
Oh, nice.
So I'm gonna grill the chicken, a little bit of olive oil, some salt.
Easy enough.
You need some help?
You've been doing great sauces for me.
Yep,
so
sauces is my speciality.
Yeah, so we're gonna meet some
gochujang.
Oh, paste.
Gochujang.
Yes.
Gochujang.
And no Russian gochujang in there.
Three of these?
Mm-hmm. I've watched them a couple of times, so I'll have
I love sesame seeds.
Yeah, it's so good.
They're so good for you, too.
Three of the paste.
Three of these.
Yep.
So what's the paste? Tomato base?
No, it's red pepper chilies base. They mix in some kind of sweet rice mixture. Get in.
Sorry, I forget my tongs, guys. Sorry.
Oh, that looks like fun.
Generous.
Two.
Generous with the mayonnaise.
Three.
I've always said that about you.
Yeah.
Generous with the mayonnaise.
That's very good.
One.
Cinnamon.
You're doing good. There you go.
Fantastic.
And then, due.
Some vinegar. Due.
That's vinegar?
Yes.
How spicy is this?
It depends. You can buy it fairly spicy or really spicy.
It's two types, huh? It's very spicy and less.
Yeah, this is less spicy.
How That's would this differ from what you find in the street?
Well, normally the chicken's on a skewer.
It's a barbecue chicken on a skewer.
Yeah, it's not a big sandwich culture there.
Oh, right, right,
bread,
no bread. There are not many sweets, no bread.
I know.
I think Koreans are like Australians. They're like party people.
They like to
have a good time.
I think so.
Definitely.
Eat, have a good time, party, a little bit of work.
Karaoke?
Yes, anyone knows if you have a business meeting, you take them all to karaoke, you get smashed, and the deal's done.
Yeah. Don't you do karaoke as well? Because Marsha does it every week,
right? She's every Monday night. Every Monday night.
Every Monday and Fridays too, right?
Sometimes.
Here we go. So we're going to add a little bit of
Do the paste first?
The paste on the bottom, yeah.
Okay.
Am I...
Give it a nice schmear.
More
of
that?
Okay, maybe you shouldn't have on both sides. And I.
Okay.
And then you do
I'll
the
do
less
only one
spicy
side, maybe.
Okay, fine.
You like spicy, Deb, right?
Yeah, I like
You know
spicy.
What? Let's just do it like this. So we're good.
There you go.
Perfect.
Good.
I just need that other bun, babe.
Yep. Right here.
Yep.
Perfect. So now we're going to chop it with the chicken.
Great. So I still have to get you guys to norebang, which is karaoke.
Not a chance.
What's it called? Norebang?
It's called norebang.
What's your first song?
My
what do you
very
warm up
first
with every,
song, I think, would have to night. Be probably Bad Romance by Lady Gaga.
How does that go?
I'm going to kill you.
Oh, no,
we're missing alcohol. I need some alcohol here.
Bad Romance, that's a relatively new song. So you don't have
it
a
is.
Go-to song that you've always had.
Well, it used to be Stevie Wonder. I just called to say I love you, but everybody's sick of it.
I'm not sick of it.
We're not sick of it. Come on.
No.
Come on.
come on, you two are the singers. Come on,
I said
rendition.
No.
You can do it.
Come on.
I love you.
I just called to say how much I care.
Come on, Jojo.
Oh, and you have a voice too.
I just called.
Better with alcohol.
To say I love you.
Hey.
And I mean it from the
bottom. See, I don't do that part.
Come on.
You can do it. Let's go back to food a little bit.
All right. Oh, okay.
I'm more comfortable than
that. Yeah, he hates it.
No, I don't hate it. I just can't sing.
Oh, so what's that? Daikon?
Asian
no,
pear.
No, this is Asian pear.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
It's like the kind of sweet, but it gives a nice texture.
And
to
this is
like a chizo. You can use chizo, which is like almost like basil and mint at the same time.
Basil and mint together. Yeah. My favorite.
Oh.
Here we go.
Fantastic.
Mm. Oh, that's sensational.
That's crazy.
Yeah, there we go.
Oh, you there?
Oh, thank you.
Thanks, babe.
You?
Wow.
Cheers.
Thank
Cheers.
You.
Here we go again.
Here we go again. Watch your...
Maybe a little
do
spicy.
The, do the hunch.
Maybe a little spicy. Oh, man. Here we go.
That's good.
Yeah. Mm. And spicy? The sesame's on the top as well.
Are you dying with the heat? It's hot. I think we got a sweater.
Kicking in. Not far. See, when do these, where do you get these ideas, like the Asian pear? When does that come to you? Or is that you? Is that your recipe?
No, this is
I'll try it first. I think it needs a little sweetness, a little crunch, so just add it on.
Are you ever wrong? Do you ever go, oh, that's
terrible? Yeah, of course.
Really?
We have a lot of flaps.
No, we're not modest.
We do have a lot of flaps.
But you would get to it like an artist.
I always love the story about the molten lava cake.
Yeah.
The most popular dessert in the world.
That was your mistake.
Not a mistake. We did a party for 500 people. When we put all the souffle in, when you put 500 brownie in the oven, the temperature of the oven dropped down. So we served it out, because it usually takes 5 minutes.
500 people.
On that time, it was 5 minutes wasn't enough, because you have so much, you put 500 in the same oven,
yeah.
It dropped the temperature down.
Right.
We served it, when they cracked it up, and it was raw in the middle.
Were you mortified?
I was like green, hiding in the fridge. And when I come out, they do my standing ovation.
Standing ovation.
Oh, isn't that crazy?
It was on the menu the next day.
Seriously, that's dessert amazing. Is in every
and that's
restaurant.
That's my favorite. That's my favorite. That's what I always tell my
that's
son.
That's the truth.
My 10-year-old who paints, and he always goes, oh, I made a mistake. And I go, no, that's the magic. You know, that's where you find the magic, is in the mistakes. And I think it's true.
Because
then
true.
Then you improvise on that. And who knows what you find there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm just getting it everywhere.
Speaking of first dates, one of the things I loved about Deb was when we ate, about a third of a meal was in her hair, on her thing, all around her mouth.
Hence the
I had a good time. When I eat, let's go.
And I thought, yep, my kind of chick right there.
I hope you enjoy.
Three. It's easy so
to
do. Good.
So much flavor,
Yeah, kid friendly.
I'm packing the school lunches tomorrow. This is what they're going to school with.
Seriously, when I next go to Seoul, that's it.
One final note. When I'm back in Korea eating in a night market, singing at Norebang, or relaxing with my friends in our favorite tent in Seoul, the nighttime is when I really feel Korean. Maybe it's a combination of good eating and drinking,
99 bottles of soju,
or the slightly magical, endless feeling of a great night out.
Take one down and pass it around.
But mostly, I think it's a comfortable and familiar approach Koreans have to spending time with family and friends that makes me feel like I'm at home.
It's a simple